Today, I would like to, we will first discuss how we will move with the class, who all will teach what all, and what is our approach. And you all must be giving for 2019. Okay? And do you understand how to handle general studies 2019? This is our target. And have you seen this year's prelims paper?
Yes.
So there was a lot of things which were from current and very unexpected type of paper. So paper will continue to keep on giving shocks and surprises. But we should be prepared for any sort of paper because selection is always comparative. How others, if something is coming out of blue moon, then nobody will be knowing this. But we should know how to make intelligent guess. Intelligent guess can come when you have the basic knowledge. So fundamental knowledge never loses its importance. Fine? And ideally, you should start your preparation with mains. Mains, one who will prepare mains can easily qualify prelims. And if you qualify prelims without preparation of mains, then also it is useless. So every student, you should have a working plan. Like 8 months are remaining, 12 months are remaining. How I am going to organize my time? And another thing is, in mains, some students, they start answer writing practice from the very beginning. First thing is, you can write answer when you have proper information. At this stage, your focus is on collection of information, relevant information, and okay, collection of the basic data. Answer writing can be learned very easily. Subject to the condition, your concepts are clear. Subject to the condition, you have information. So, hamara first task kya hai? Get information and have an exhaustive study. Up, if you see UPSC, two aspects are there. First is the static part and second is the dynamic part. It is also wrong if we completely ignore static, because you can make sense of dynamic part only when you do static. For example, the national population or population register in case of Assam. To understand this issue, you have to go back into the history of Assam, how a movement against outsiders started, what all has been the developments, what have been the Assam Accord, what is the information or what all positions Supreme Court has taken, okay? So same thing is in international relations. It is just a misunderstanding that anything is entirely current or anything is entirely static. Fine. Now, with this particular class, we will be dealing with a static and dynamic portion up till now, whatever development has happened. Okay? And we will try our best that you understand the issues. Whenever you also study, try to understand the crux of the thing or the basic concepts have to be very, very clear. Now, at the same time, in this class, we have, in a routine manner, included current affairs. okay. So initially students find difficulty in understanding the newspapers, many things keep on happening. So we will be covering, suppose with economy it will be static as well as dynamic, but at the same time separately we will also be dealing with current affairs. Second thing is, normally what happens, we read new thing, we forget the old, okay. So that is why, though right now not required, but in the present program we have included a system of test, a weekly test, both objective and subjective. Okay, so objective test, whatever topic whosoever will be teaching, you should be revising those topics. In a week there will be an objective test, at least that habit develops. Similarly, subjective test, though not required that you write answers now, but you have to learn how to write, and writing should become a habit. Whatever we study, it has to be a result oriented, otherwise it's all waste if result does not come. Okay, so what I have learned, how will I come to know I really understood? Only through writing. So that's why these two things we have introduced, and you maintain the momentum, because once momentum lost, regularity in class is also very important, because if you are not regular, you will lose the interest, you will lose the momentum. So test happen, it doesn't matter. Some students think I am not fully prepared. It doesn't matter. Even if you are, you should try to prepare. If you are not fully prepared, then still you write, you will get less marks. At least you will feel ashamed, okay, that I should have done it. See, it is a competition. It is, UPSC exam is not like you are coming here to gain a degree. You are coming here, all those who are sitting here and anywhere, you have to beat them. It is an issue of a race where you have to beat, and you have to consistently prove yourself better than the other. And again, better than other also involves better, you have to improve yourselves. It's actually, it is like you must enjoy taking challenge. It is your challenge, you have to take challenge. Others are competitors, but your biggest challenge is inside you. Your biggest obstacle is inside us itself. We may suffer from different type of maybe limitations. We may think, we may be not be having confidence. I have seen students who have well read, but they are not able to perform in the exam. So performance is the most important. In this exam, you are going for civil services, where what matters, you have to execute the things. Performance matter. How much you have studied does not matter, but how you have studied matter. Even if you are not reading 10 papers, you are not referring 10 websites, doing 100. I have seen a student doing questions daily, but is still not getting marks, because you are always forgetting the basics. Your basic concepts have to be very, very clear. Until unless one particular issue, suppose minimum support price, this issue has to be studied holistically. What is the problem of the farmers? What has been our policies? How it originated? Which method? What option? What policies government have taken? What policies government should take? So for UPSC, you also need lot of thinking. Rather than reading 100 things, thinking is very much required. Your mind should keep on working. It has to be an analytical mind. So first understand what is the requirement of the exam. For example, students will refer 10 books but still unable to locate the crux. Here you don't have to read 100 books to prepare a good answer. You need to have a lot of conceptual clarity to write a good answer. And then in GS, there is not much scope for good answer, bad answer. In GS, if you get the question, you understand the question, format does not matter so much. Format matters a lot in optional. Here your information will matter. So your conceptual clarity, you are updated with the current development of anything or not, that will play important role. And start from the basics. You should have a time like newspaper. Newspaper reading is the must for UPSC. Though there may be shortcuts available in the market, but these shortcuts, these monthly magazines which you say, they are nothing more than collection of facts. But you will never be able to make sense if you will just rely on the magazines. These magazines may be useful when you are giving exam, but this is the time when you have to build your capacity. Which capacity you should emphasize most? Capacity to think, capacity to analyze. At this point, there is no need that you start remembering. Our memory is short. Start understanding. Fine? Because we will learn, we will forget. Before exam, we will have time that you try to go for memorization and all. That is also required because we do not have that much time. You should be able to recollect the things and write in a particular time. So memorization important, but not from now. If you understand the things, you will never forget. Even if it is prelims, memorization not required. All the four options are given. You have to select the first option or the best option, whatever is the right option. So it's very important, analyze the things. How to start a preparation? Best guide for preparation is see the questions. Okay? See all papers, what type of questions. Read syllabus very nicely. Fine? For example, newspapers also. Though we will be providing you the monthly current affairs thing, I will also be taking up the current affairs important portions. But still, your self-study is also important of current. Because if you will not involve your mind, your ability to think and analyze will not develop. Fine? So you can start with any of the newspaper. Normally everybody starts with Hindu. Fine? So you also start with Hindu. Initially you may find it difficult because Hindu's language is not that easy. Okay? But once you will understand the constitution, economic system, social system, your understanding will obviously become better and you will start grasping. Okay? So these days I think Mint is also a good paper. If you don't want to read Hindu from the beginning, you can and find Mint simpler. Mint is giving good articles and it is also useful. It's your choice, but start with only one paper. And you keep newspaper ka organization of content is also very, very important. Fine? We keep clippings. But do you think anybody ever gets the time to read it again? That's all waste. Okay? Plus, you try to develop your capacity gradually. Don't run with 100 wala speed from the very first day. Time? So reading newspaper, it's not necessary at present that we should be able to cover the entire thing. You can take up one single issue. It is enough. Suppose change of government in Pakistan. What can be the possible implications for India? What is the politics going on? Even if you are thoroughly reading one thing, it is fine. Any development, any science technology development, one topic a day is also fine, but do something. And don't get depressed that I am unable to cover. So what you can do, develop your ambitions gradually, how much you can cover. You must be very practical in this exam. Fine, neither that, there's no idealistic type of a preparation, be very practical. For current affairs, you can make 4 separate registers for each paper, 1, 2, 3, 4. Whichever news, suppose some incident happened, government had not handled that crisis properly, it can come as a case study. So try to be creative and visualize the things. And suppose some incident happened, suppose 3 sisters died in Delhi out of hunger. This example you can use in paper 2, paper 4, where it can come. In any way, you put it there, read it. So you can also make a register which is just only for prelims for some more factual information. So first of all, organize yourself. Organize how you are going to study, how you are going to organize your information, what all sources you are going to refer, and limit yourself with that. So, sabse pehle, have you gone through the syllabus? Ab syllabus ka segregation, jaise polity hai. Polity ke 3 parts ho gaye: constitution, governance, India and the international relations. Plus question papers bhi dekho. Ab question papers mein sabse zara weightage kiska ho gaya? Polity questions. उसके बाद गवर्नेंस क्वेश्चन. अब क्वेश्चन में वी विल ऑलवेज सी कि एनजीओ या सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप से क्वेश्चन आना ही आना है. इंडिया एंड द वर्ल्ड या चाइना, इंडिया चाइना क्वेश्चन, समथिंग रिलेटेड टू दैट विल कम. तो क्वेश्चन एनालिसिस विल हेल्प यू इन स्ट्रीमलाइनिंग द प्रिपरेशन. दैट्स नॉट अ वेस्टेज ऑफ टाइम. प्लस अभी what you can do, you can start little bit with prelims preparation also. Preparation ka start hamesha question paper se hota hai. What you do, previous year question, ek particular question le karke, wo kya tha, man lo soil health, it was on soil health or something on related to the dry land farming, anything. Now the net and so many things are available, Google it. From that question, you collect the information. So in all classes, you know, I always tell, first month, you can do at least one previous year question of prelims a day. Ek daily ka make this routine. Jaise polity hai, agar usi mein ek question aa gaya, make separate copies, polity. Or aise random agar padhoge prelims, it is always better to remember. Suppose a question comes 0 hour, joint sitting. Just read what is a joint sitting. Okay, given in this particular article, it happens. Make that notes. So at least if you will go through the prelims questions of last 10 years, you will get a very good idea that when I read Lakshmikant, when I read NCERT, where I have to focus. So just don't study book in dark. You should know what I must extract from here. Yojana, 10 articles will come on the same topic. But which topic, where it is asked. So from now onwards, first of all, make a plan. It is not necessary. You can change the plan. 10 months available, 12 months available, 8 months available. I will take this portion. But have a plan. Have your own plan. See, you are going to be an administrator, planner. In a planning, you should have, you should know as a, in practical, whatever is required in the practical field of administration is just an exam. So in India, administration always has limited resources, but still they are expected to perform. Similarly, in exam, your study will never be complete. Still you are expected to perform and you get results also. So it's a, ठीक है, उनको बुला है ना, तो इट इज़ अ प्रोसेस, फाइन. तो अभी वी विल स्टार्ट आवर क्लास विथ हिस्ट्री, वी विल स्टार्ट विथ मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री. जय सर विल टेक मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री. यू फर्स्ट स्टडी फ्रॉम मेंस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, साइड बाय साइड स्टार्ट डूइंग विथ प्रिलिम्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. तो एटलीस्ट वी विल स्टार्ट 3 days हिस्ट्री and 3 days geography. ठीक है, साइड बाई साइड एटलीस्ट सी प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस ऑफ GS मेन्स हिस्ट्री. अब हिस्ट्री तो इज नॉट दैट डायनेमिक, हिस्ट्री तो फिर से रिपीट, बट नेचर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस यू शुड नो सो दैट यू कैन टेक द मैक्सिमम एडवांटेज ऑफ द क्लास. यू शुड नो दैट इफ सर इज टीचिंग गांधी, I must be clear in these dimensions of Gandhi. ठीक है, तो एक तो exam के लिए what you require, it is your entire result should be, you should be very professional, you should be very result oriented. Whatever I study, why I am studying? I am not studying to know Gandhi. I am studying to know, to get marks. That is the only objective. How to maximize marks, this is my objective. So discipline is very important, whichever topic that is being started. So it will be a good homework if you go through the syllabus, note down the syllabus of modern India, mains and prelims. Next 2-3 days, note down all mains questions that have been asked. It's not a waste exercise. Don't go on the ready-made notes. Ready-made question analysis is there, but you write in your handwriting. Things will remain in your mind. Then prelims questions of previous year history, side by side. Okay? And don't adopt shortcuts. No use. Shortcuts only result into wastage of time. People say there is no need to read. For example, let's say Bipin Chandra's book, Spectrum is enough. Spectrum is enough, but only once you know. Because when you read a book of a good writer, not only your understanding is improving, your expression, your language, there are many benefits we do not realize. When you read an article from Hindu, you learn many things which we don't realize. So start in a very scientific, in a very systematic manner. We will also be giving you some assignments from time to time. We'll try that few things which normally we are unable to cover, but important. Jaise India yearbook hai, yojana hai. Agar isko hum abhi se start karte hain, lekin kis dhang se kare so that it becomes productive. So abhi, from now till December, okay, you focus on your collection of information, data, learning ho jayega, but samajhna is very, very important. Fine?